Welcome back, everybody. We're here on the beach at Riptide Sunday. Yeah. So we're here at the Pavilion, Celebration Sea Pavilion, literally live on one of the most beautiful beaches in the world. And right behind us is some of the most beautiful water in the world, right? Love to dive in that stuff.
Amazing. Amazing day, beautiful water, perfect day at the beach.
So we are having a perfect day at the beach. I want to introduce some great friends, and first do a quick shout out for my friends in Innovative Group, our presenting sponsors of the Eco Discovery Zone. We got all this cool diving stuff and science and all that happening. So let's start with Tommy, my dear friend Tommy, who made a lot of this happen, got on the phone and said, Tommy, you want to be here at Riptide? I said, come in, baby. And he brought Rob around. So thank you guys so much for coming down with Shipwreck Park and being with us today. So also Rob is with Tommy. How did this all start with you guys in Shipwreck Park? And tell us about the organization, because cool stuff.
Well, the whole idea started many, many years ago. There was a number of citizens in Pompano, Tommy being one of them, that was
Pompano Beach, interested in sinking, acquiring, and putting
a large vessel on the bottom to really enhance the dive market, put us on the map from a tourism destination standpoint, and obviously improve the fishery. So that idea had been kicking around for a number of years, and I think it was about 3 years ago that we got pretty serious about trying to make it happen. Initially, we thought this was in the $5 to $10 million range, and we were putting task force together about how to raise money and, you know, how to do this and acquire a big naval vessel and all of that. And then we finally discovered, thanks to...
And it's just not just the acquiring, you got to sink the thing.
Oh, yeah,
which is
and sinking, right? You know, acquire, decommission,
prep
make
it,
safe.
Pull the oil all out of it and clean it up. And,
So, Pachi, it goes back. Captain Slate, and I asked if I knew Captain Slate. So,
Captain
way back
Slate's
in 2006 and 2007. We were trying to sink a large vessel, the Eriskany. And that's when we met Jeff Turode and I and some
a
few folks up in the county were trying to get that ship. Mm-hmm. He was integral in trying to make that happen with us. Unfortunately, there were some political issues and it went off the north. Beautiful dive, you know the Eriskany, but we were trying to get it here. So that's when this all started, the idea of it started.
Yeah, how great.
And actually, the Mayor Lamar Fisher put a task force together for a lot of things. And one of them was about tourism, and that's kind of when this thing took off, when we were thinking about how we could, you know, enhance our position as a tourist destination. And that's what really, I think, provided the impetus to getting Shipwreck Park moving.
And you've done studies, the actual ROI, return on investment, when you sink a vessel like that, you guys had NOAA provide some data in terms of how valuable that is and how quickly. It was about a $900,000 investment to sink it, right?
Right.
To buy it, commission it, or decommission it and sink it.
Exactly.
And then within just a couple months, how long?
Three months, it actually
paid for itself.
Just in tourism dollars.
Incredible.
And what we're talking about is tourism, but that's just kind of that's really not the reason to do it. The reason we've done it is to take the pressure off the natural reef system.
Yep.
That's the reason why all artificial reefs are created. Whether they're shallow water reefs or deep water reefs, the reason they're created is to take the pressure off the natural reef system. And as you know, and you've been working on all weekend, I've been listening to seminars you've been doing, and it's been phenomenal. You know, 8% of the water of the seas is shallow waters, but that holds over 50% of all marine life. Mm-hmm. And of that 50%, 25% are born and raised on the coral reef system.
So in terms of habitat, providing a place for the...
Exactly.
You talked about the fisheries and the benefit. All of us emotionally who love the ocean think about what we can do to help with all the pressure we're putting on it, make something cool happen. But the fact that we can not only do something from a habitat and an environmental perspective, but it's economically beneficial. This is the wonderful thing about understanding how doing good is actually doing good, right?
That's exactly right.
We kind of stumbled into this, too, because... The idea was about tourism and in enhancing, moving Pompano Beach to a better destination point. But the more we got working on this, the more we started looking into the real benefits of the reef, we have really kind of morphed towards the educational component. And everything that we're trying to do, in our mission statement, if I'll read it for you, Shipwreck Park is a not-for-profit organization dedicated to the creation of an underwater park system establishing artificial reefs, utilizing public art to raise awareness of the need to preserve and conserve our natural coral reef system. That was the aha moment, I think, for me anyway. And we did this in a workshop probably 6-9 months ago. And that's where we're headed now. The reefs, the wreck sinkings and things will take care of themselves as far as being publicized. The dive community is very, very tight. So that will still benefit the community in all South Florida. But it's really about the education that we're focusing on now.
For those of you who have... you know and appreciate if you've been on a big wreck, when you get down there on the bottom and you see this just spectacular thing, especially after it's been down there a few years with the coral that comes on it and the pelagic and all the fish that are around it. It's something so visceral when you see a shipwreck down there for us divers. It's powerful stuff. It's rock and roll. I mean, that's exciting stuff. Right?
It's truly incredible. And you know what we've done too with our wrecks and really creating this underwater arts park is we're putting art on all the wrecks. We have a world-renowned artist, Dennis McDonald, who is our partner. He's done both of the large ships that we've done. He's created these unbelievable, whimsical
figures. You want to show
him some
pictures? Yeah. What are you talking about?
Absolutely.
So we'll talk before about we this. Get past this, so explain what we're looking at.
So this is the Newtown Creek. This is a very, very interesting vessel. This vessel was commissioned in 1963 for the purpose of carrying human waste from New York City offshore. It's an offshore vessel, dumping it offshore, what they thought was a safe distance, to where it could be taken care of by Mother Earth, right?
Yeah, right.
Well, along with the EPA and I think a couple of bad days where the effluent actually washed up in New Jersey, she was decommissioned as an underwater vessel and was relegated to carrying waste from Manhattan to a sewage treatment plant, I think, in northern New Jersey. She was decommissioned, I believe, 2012, 2013. But one interesting story about this, and we have a video, you talk about Erie. This was only one of very, very few vessels that was operating the day after 9/11. We have video of her going by the World Trade Center, doing what she was supposed to be doing.
Really?
Operating that day under armed guard with the Coast Guard and naval vessels. So very interesting story.
Wow.
Anyway, she was decommissioned, and Greg Harrison, the city manager for Pompano Beach, discovered her out there, and we went into a long negotiation process with the City of New York Environmental and DEQ to acquire it.
And we want your ship.
We want your ship. Yeah. But it was a double-edged sword because she was a ship that had a job to do, but it wasn't the most pleasant job. But we took the lemons and made lemonade out of it and brought her down here, decommissioned her and sunk her in July of 2016.
How big is that thing?
324 feet.
324 feet. Yeah. Amazing. Yep. So when Tommy was talking about the art, so explain to people what you've done with it. It's really interesting. When you get down there, it's not just a shipwreck. It's actually living art too, right?
So what we wanted to do was to create this art component of the sinking. We met Dennis McDonald, who actually lives in Pompano Beach, but he's a world-renowned artist. He's done work all over the country. He did the Hoover Dam Tourist Center in Nevada, so he's done work in Las Vegas, done work everywhere. He came on board and has been just an absolute asset to our organization.
Wonderful. Love that octopus.
So
go
what we
Riptide.
Did is, right,
our mascot of Riptide. Yeah, Ozzy the octopus.
Been in the casino business, you know, there's nothing more whimsical than an octopus dealing a crack game.
And one of your wonderful sponsors actually made this happen was the casino, right?
So it was a public-private sponsorship.
Shout out to them.
It was between the Isle Casino Racing in Pompano Beach and the City of Pompano Beach each put in $300,000
to really seed
the project. And that's how we got. And so we took the casino theme. We renamed the Newtown Creek Lady Luck for that very purpose. And then had Dennis commission all this art for us.
How great. So these pictures, now what are we looking at here?
This is the actual sinking day.
She's going down. Yeah.
She was supposed to go down about 1 o'clock on Saturday afternoon. I don't think she made the bottom to 4:17?
Yeah, a little after 4 o'clock. It took a while, but it was a very controlled sink. We want to make sure we did it right. And she said,
you guys were chewing her nails the whole time, right?
It started off a little bit nervous.
Because everybody wants to make sure it goes down the right way. Because sometimes they don't end up where you want them, right?
Well, she started listing.
Slate knows that the hard way, right?
She started listing about 30 degrees, and she backed off, thank goodness, and went straight up and down.
I saw some cool footage. You probably see it on YouTube, right? Of the GoPros you had all over the ship.
It's awesome.
Is it on YouTube if people want to see it?
They are on YouTube. Well,
how do they find it? You got to check this out.
Shipwreck Park, our YouTube site there, all of those are linked to it.
And you can see the Lady Luck going down.
Yes. Absolutely. Right?
Yeah. Yes.
So these shots, now, how long ago was that?
This is a shot taken by a local artist, a photographer named Kevin Hansen. This was taken probably 100 days ago. Mm-hmm. So that's what's happened.
So how many years? When was it?
One.
That's so 1 year
that
later?
That was less than a year.
The living, these are all living things going on with the coral, and it's starting to come living reef. Yeah.
How amazing. That's 1 year.
Incredible. Okay, and what are we looking at there?
Our second vessel was a 103-foot tug I think it was commissioned and run by the Army Corps of Engineers, I believe, had it.
Oh, cool.
And she was also retired, going to get sold for scrap, and we picked her up. This actually, we weren't looking for this one, but she came our way, and we just couldn't turn it down because it was such a great vessel because we were allowed to put it in much shallower water.
And that's a big deal because this vessel right here at 107 feet, and with our partnership with the county, Ken Banks and his team are phenomenal. They're really part of the Environmental Artificial Reef Program that they've been working on since 1980. Yeah. But they said they found a spot for us, and they said if you can get a small enough vessel that's going to be really cool, we can get it in shallow water.
Yep.
So we sunk this thing in 70 feet of water, under 70 feet of water, which is incredible. And on a clear day like today, you could see her from the surface.
So in the sand, it's at 107, and what's actually the...
In the sand, she's at 70 feet.
Oh, wow. Really?
The Okinawa's in 70.
It's 107 feet long.
107 feet long, okay. So the bottom of it's 70 feet, and then at the tower...
Just a little under 40 feet.
40 feet. So a 40-foot dive, you can still get to it and have
absolutely.
A nice...
Absolutely. See all the artwork beautifully.
Yeah. And then this is some of the art you were talking about,
so
Tommy,
what we
right
wanted there. To do, aside from the art that Dennis did, is we commissioned the children in Pompano Beach Cultural Arts Center that were there on
cool
a summer
to
program
it.
To paint these.
How cool.
And we affixed them to the side of the stack and got a lot of pictures of some kids having some fun. And they did some educating and talking
go
about
arts.
Coral
yeah.
Reef. Yeah, it absolutely...
Go Wyland, go Groupers.
Yeah.
All right.
So that's what
arts.
We're doing right now. If when you look around and the folks that are coming out today, come paint with Wyland.
Yeah.
Hopefully you'll submit your project and we're going to look at them. And the top 20, we're going to get and make the little bolts like this. And we're going to deploy them on our next
what do you think, Groupers? Cool? You guys don't see them on camera. Wyland's Groupers are here. They're always so kind. Thank you guys for showing up at all our events.
Thank you, guys.
So this one, this is interesting. So she's down there on the wreck?
She's out in the wreck. We have to replace the ball. The storm tore it up pretty good. It drug
this
her about
Irma?
100 feet.
What storm? Irma
Okinawa.
Whacked it?
Yeah.
Irma did a lot of stuff. Yeah.
But we're going to get we've got the ball back. We're going to get that.
So this shot, how cool is that? You can see the diver here shooting with the camera in the ball.
Another aha moment was looking in this ball, because every time you look at the ball, you're really gazing at yourself.
Yeah, yeah.
So we've saying that anybody looking in this, gazing at themselves in this ball, has to expect responsibility.
That's an extraordinary shot. It really is, huh?
It's
you get
eerie.
Kind of this feeling of the, especially with the bubbles. And wow.
And you know, when you walk by our booth here today, we talk about, we have that ball and that gazing ball, and there's probably been 300 or 400 pictures taken on the beach. And like Rob's saying, it's really that aha moment when you're looking at it, you say, hey, your reflection's back at you. It's a beautiful mermaid, but the reflection's back at you.
Yeah.
You have a responsibility to protect our reef system and
absolutely.
Our ocean system too.
Absolutely. So this one, that's
another photo that Kevin took probably 30 days ago. That is what the Okinawa looks today.
Yep.
Obviously a pretty low visibility
and
day.
And that's 70 feet there.
But
that's
she's listing. Yeah,
the
she's
top
listing.
Of the tower's about 40.
Yeah.
Yep.
When she first sunk, she was upright. Now she's listing a bit.
Did Irma do that?
Irma did that.
Oh,
thanks,
Irma. You are just.
But she's still in the same spot, and it's still a beautiful dive.
So what is next, guys? What's going on with you next?
Go ahead, Tommy.
Well, I'll tell you, where we've really gotten to is these large artificial reef projects are fantastic. They're expensive, and they do some great stuff, and we get some great international publicity. But what we really are moving to, and we're talking about, is the education of the kids, especially in Broward County. So we want to get a site that's really accessible to folks that don't scuba dive. So that means snorkeling.
Yeah, absolutely.
That means snorkeling.
Yeah.
That means a shallow water. So what we're working on, and again, we're in the early stages. The county is looking at it. We're doing some surveys of the ground, make sure we don't see grass, make sure we don't get hurt any of that. But we've found a spot in northern Broward County, about 12 feet of water, that really, if we can pull it off, it's adjacent a park, a city park right now. We're having an interactive exhibit from a land to the ocean where you can actually walk right down
cool.
in on a ramp.
Yeah.
And it's all about education. We've
like
already
that.
Talked to the school system. They're completely on board
can
bringing the buses.
Can people support you? Is there a website? Are you guys doing crowdfunding? Or how do we help you with that?
If you can go
that's
to shipwreckpark.org, it's mm-hmm. Shipwreck Park, Florida, Shipwreck Park, Pompano, Shipwreck,
yep.
all of those Shipwreck Park.
Can they volunteer to help you guys? Or are you
absolutely.
Funding?
As we get there, we've still got some preliminary work to get through. Mm-hmm. It's going to be a long road, but with the end of the story would be huge if we can make it happen.
How exciting.
It's for everybody. I mean, disabled, children, it addresses what, it will be able to address what your previous speakers talked about with sea rise. I mean, we're leaving the world to the kids. I mean, yep. You know,
like, got to get those kids out there and get wet.
Yeah.
And it truly is going to use in the arts to promote education of conservation. Yep. That's exactly what we're about.
Amen.
In three simple words: arts,
we'll
conservation,
keep up the great
education.
Work. What is the website if people want to find you guys?
Shipwreckpark.org.
Shipwreckpark.org. So thank you guys so much for being
thanks,
part
Pachi.
Of
Pachi, thanks for doing this.
At the pavilion. And hopefully we'll be getting
it.
Wet. We'd love to do some live stuff with you guys underwater. We got some ideas, and we're probably going to drag Ashley and Toast and all our friends from Intercom down there, get them really wet. They haven't been certified yet, but by the time we get them on a shipwreck,
we're going to get them certified.
Yeah, we'll get them wet. Right.
Not a problem.
Thank you guys so much for coming.
Thanks.
So everyone stay tuned.
Thanks,
we'll be here all weekend on Facebook Live.